My name.
Yes.
That could be on in the background. That's a lovely background. Yeah, that's fine.
I was in the restroom when I heard my name. Hi there, hi, Noon Saloon.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Stopped there for the summer, so I thought. I got there and
announced at the end of the summer, they said, my mom said, I'm going home. You get to stay here with your stepfather on sabbatical and go to Mexican private school and learn Mexican, learn Spanish, they called it. And I wasn't too good on that. I was put in a first grade class where I had a tiny desk, even tinier than this chair, even tinier than a tiny man that's about to play tiny. And the only salvation was the record store at Plaza del Sol. It was down on Vallarta Avenue, a couple of miles from Chapulitas where I lived. And they gave me my allowance one day, and I went in and I bought a copy of Yes's Close to the Edge. We didn't have a turntable, but I needed something to soothe my soul. And the only thing I could find in Guadalajara, Mexico, was a copy of the Yes album that I had no idea what it was about. It was a Spanish copy. It was printed in Spain. It didn't have the lyrics or anything. I couldn't listen to it. I could only imagine what it was. It was probably like those concerts I had seen when I was a younger boy, when I was stoned in Berkeley in San Francisco, and had held this stuff up to the light of escape, because childhood was escape to me. And I didn't know where I was escaping to, but I had this record. And they swore at me, they cursed, they said, why the hell would you buy a piece of vinyl? We're in Mexico, it's hot as hell, we're driving through the desert to get back home. And I said, because it can save my life from you intolerable people. Little did I know that I would be a musician. I sang, I imitated birds, hence the soundtrack of every album you've ever heard me record. It starts off like that, like the beginning of Close to the Edge. And which the ending of the album is about people singing in Siberia in strange voices. Who the hell knew that? I'm watching my F-bombs because of audience members. I'm a good boy. I didn't know what this madman poetry was. I didn't know what these English pompous musicians were doing, the folks that Spinal Tap would be based on. I just knew that if I kept in my ways and escaped in this music forever, that I might have a chance to make it. So I took some notes here, and there are parts of the song, and I threw the notes away, probably. Themes, river, running, sad, courage, in charge of, that's ever, it's a river, it's a river, it's a river, they keep saying. The second side starts with the song that I imagine Mr. Mackey opening, okay, and goes into "And You and I." Are these songs about God? Are they songs about love? Are there songs about the woman that you can never get? Well, I think through the years of developing this thing, I realized that they were songs about whatever God meant to me. Thank you. space agreed. Story is in this book, and I'm honored and privileged to be amongst you, and I want to hear your story.